A police blitz in the western suburbs has netted 50 arrests as police try to stop youth gangs preying on other teens during the school holidays. Victims of crime say the crackdown highlights the need for tougher bail laws to keep repeat offenders off the streets.
A suspected gang member arrested as police try to control spiralling youth crime in Melbourne's west, part of a four-day blitz in the Hobsons Bay, Maribyrnong, Wyndham and Brimbank council areas. The state government today trying to defend laws which allow young offenders to be repeatedly released on bail. The latest case, a 16-year-old accused of a violent baseball bat attack, freed three times.
That's not to say that in this instance is not something that the government is concerned about, but that was a matter for the judge.
Of the 50 arrests in the police crackdown, 20 were children aged 10 to 17, 15 were 18 to 24, and in total, 31 have been charged so far. But big changes are needed, say victims of youth crime in the west, like 16-year-old Ryan Singh, who was stabbed and bashed unconscious in a random attack in Tarneit last year.
That night it was me, and another night it could be someone else, and I don't think anyone deserves that. So that's why the system should change and laws for these youths should be harder.
How many more families and how many more kids needs to be go through what we went through for government to step up?
The timing of the blitz was deliberate, just as Easter and the school holidays were starting. That's when police say youth gangs are more likely to attack young victims around transport hubs, parks and shopping centres.
We've seen changes to the bail laws over recent months, making it easier for repeat offenders, particularly repeat offenders who are committing serious crimes, being easier to get out on bail.
If passed, the government's new youth justice bill will include a trial of electronic monitoring for 50 bailed youths, but it's unlikely until late in the year, even next year.
Government, sometimes I feel like they're blindfolded, they're not listening, they're not watching, and they don't care.
Paul Dowsley, 7 News.